A very good evening. You're watching News 9 with me, Akshita. And first up, Nawaz Sharif's visit to India has sparked a lot of controversies in India as well as Pakistan. While there are innumerable speculations on what transpired during the meet, it seems that Pakistan is breathing fire on its Prime Minister for not raising several issues.
Ruckus in Pakistan Punjab Assembly. Tables anti-Modi resolution. Pakistan Punjab Assembly still breathing fire over Nawaz Sharif visiting India and giving a nod to whatever Modi had demanded. In fact, they have condemned Narendra Modi for accusing Pakistan of cross-border terrorism. Not just that, they have also gone on to say that there were several baseless allegations leveled against Pakistan during that historic meet. They also raised the issue of Balochistan and Kashmir in the assembly. Here is a brief look into the key issues discussed in Pakistan Punjab Assembly that was today a house of chaos. Members of the Pakistan Punjab Assembly raised many key issues that plagued them from the time Nawaz Sharif visited India. First and foremost being, they demanded our new Prime Minister stop accusing Pakistan of cross-border terrorism. Not just that, they raised the issue of terror in Balochistan and demanded that India should stop giving financial assistance to terror outfits in the region. After accusing India of assisting terror outfits in Balochistan, they also demanded India to stop the illegal occupancy in Pakistan and that a visit and a handshake was a goodwill gesture and that it shouldn't be mistaken for weakness. While India saw Nawaz Sharif's visit as an optimistic move, it seems Nawaz Sharif is paying for it in his own territory. A News 9 report.
And a day after accompanying PM Narendra Modi in meeting leaders of all the SAARC nations, Sushma Swaraj today assumed office. And almost instantly, the Congress began a tirade against Swaraj and BJP. Take a look.
First woman MEA takes charge. Senior BJP leader Sushma Swaraj, who now holds the distinction of being the country's first woman external affairs minister, assumed office today. She was received by Foreign Secretary Sujata Singh with a bouquet. Although most of Modi's cabinet ministers took charge yesterday, Sushma had an eventful day accompanying PM Modi while meeting all the SAARC leaders who were in New Delhi. Upon assuming office, Sushma said that her priority is to showcase India's strengths to the world and further improve relations with other countries.
भारत की ताकत को यानी जो स्ट्रेंथ से हमारी ताकत का मतलब मैं फिजिकल स्ट्रेंथ से नहीं कह रही जो स्ट्रेंथ से हमारी उनको रखना और पूरे विश्व के देशों के साथ भारत के संबंध बहुत अच्छे करना और इसमें सबसे पहले आते हैं पड़ोसी देश जिनसे शुरुआत कल हो चुकी है ये सारे जितने देश हैं इन देशों के साथ हम लोगों का संबंध अच्छा हो ये सुषमा स्वराज की भारतीय सरकार की तरफ से प्राथमिकता होगी
A tough MEA complimenting tough PM. This is the big question doing the rounds in the political circles following Sushma taking charge of External Affairs Ministry. A day after the country's hard-hitting PM Narendra Modi was reported to be vocal against terrorism originating from Pakistan during talks with Nawaz Sharif, Sushma today seemed to carry on the momentum. The new cabinet minister quoted PM Narendra Modi and said that sound of talks get lost in the sound of bombs in an apparent reference to terrorism talks between the two PMs.
हम लोगों ने पाकिस्तान से जब बात की तो ये कहा कि ये चाहते हैं लेकिन अच्छे रिश्तों में जो बातचीत की बात है वो बातचीत सफल और सही तभी हो सकती है जब पहले आतंक बंद हो जिसको प्रधानमंत्री कहते हैं कि बम धमाके की आवाज में बात की आवाज रुक जाती है सुनाई नहीं पड़ती इन्हीं शब्दों में उन्होंने उनसे कहा इसलिए बम धमाके बंद हो और हम बात करें तो आवाज दोनों को सुनाई देगी लेकिन अगर बम धमाके चलते रहेंगे तो उसमें बात की आवाज दब जाएगी
Further, Sushma confirmed that the talks between Prime Minister Narendra Modi and SAARC leaders were successful.
समारोह में SAARC देशों के जो राष्ट्राध्यक्ष आए थे उनके साथ कल प्रतिनिधि मंडलों की बैठक थी और प्रधानमंत्री जी ने सभी आठों से कल चर्चा की उन सभी टॉक्स में मैंने उनको असिस्ट किया लेकिन मैं आपको ये बताना चाहूंगी कि जो टॉक्स हुई मैं उनको बहुत सफल टॉक्स की संज्ञा इस मायने में देती हूँ.
Congress launches a scathing attack. The Congress, which suffered a crushing defeat in the hands of Modi-led BJP in the Lok Sabha polls, was quick to launch an attack. Minutes after Sushma Swaraj assumed office and made her first address, former Cabinet Minister Manish Tiwari took pot shots at the former, accusing the BJP of double standards.
The broad message which has gone to the various actors in Pakistan is that whatever the Bharatiya Janata Party had been articulating over the past 10 years was merely political rhetoric. On the very first day of assuming office, they have done a complete U-turn. And insofar as they are concerned, it seems ostensibly that terror and talks, unfortunately, in their dictionary, once they are in government, perhaps can go together.
Well, Sushma Swaraj has taken charge of her office on a high note and in tune with Modi's style of governance. And the Congress too has begun playing the role of the opposition. While the row over bilateral talks with Pakistan is turning into a political debate, it remains to be seen how the talks will have its effect on ground. A news and quote.
Even as Sushma reiterated what Modi had spoken with regards to the meet with Nawaz Sharif, the situation in Islamabad is contrasting. The media has gone all out on Nawaz Sharif's visit to India, despite the Pakistani government calling the meet a success.
Sartaz Aziz, the advisor to the Pakistan Prime Minister, echoed India's thoughts on the bilateral talks between the prime ministers of the two countries that was held in the national capital yesterday. Meet more than just a photo op.
The Prime Minister undertook this visit with a clear vision in mind, based on strategic calculation and not just for a photo op.
Outcome much better than expected.
Although the visit was essentially a ceremonial occasion, where Pakistan together with other SAARC countries participated in the spirit of SAARC fraternity, the actual result and outcome was much better than we had expected.
A historic beginning.
The Prime Ministers agreed that it was a historic opportunity for both the countries to mark a new beginning in bilateral ties. Both felt the need to turn a new page in our relations.
Composite dialogue agreed.
The meeting was held in a cordial atmosphere where both sides expressed their views on all issues of common concern. There was clear recognition of each other's concern and the need for a mechanism to address them.
Although Aziz stressed that talks between the leaders of the two nations were a success, the neighboring country's media was not convinced. Prime Minister Nawaz Sharif, who returned to Islamabad last evening, was greeted by a volley of criticism. The Pakistan media hit out against him for failing to mention the Kashmir issue, even as he had been greeted with the issue of terrorism. India visit a success, insists Sharif aides. This was a headline in Pakistan's famed newspaper Dawn, following Aziz's statement on bilateral talks. The headline was followed with lines which called Islamabad's statement desperate. It did not take long for the Prime Minister's senior aides to jump into action and address the criticism. They tried hard to convince many that the meeting had been a success. Yesterday, the same newspaper carried an editorial which firmly believed that the meet would not result in anything significant. Pak India, more of the same. Under this slug, the editorial accused Nawaz Sharif of going soft as opposed to a hard-hitting Indian Prime Minister. The article further said that the Indian diplomats clearly portrayed that the attempt to bridge the gap between India and Pakistan will be an uphill task. Sticking to his pre-election script of focusing on building closer economic ties while downplaying the big historical security issues, Nawaz Sharif said many of the right things and tried his best to sustain the feel-good factor of his presence in Delhi. Yet, as snippets from the meeting between Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi and Mr. Sharif were leaked to the Indian media, and then India's own diplomats chose to take a tough line in public, it became clear, as if more clarity were needed, just how difficult it will continue to be to bridge the gap between India's almost exclusive focus on terrorism and Pakistan's wanting to expand talks to encompass many of the long-standing issues between the two sides. The newspaper even went on to question the intentions of Modi's government when it came to normalization of ties with Pakistan. As ever, there are tough questions to be asked about the intentions and or capacity of both sides to deliver on their rhetoric of peace. Is Mr. Modi really interested in moving forward on normalization of ties with Pakistan? The generous explanation would cast Mr. Modi's invitation to Mr. Sharif as a signal that the new Indian government wants to work on improving ties with Pakistan immediately and perhaps even meaningfully. The less charitable explanation would be that Mr. Modi has cleverly bought himself goodwill internationally by hosting Mr. Sharif, but did so in a way that really conceded nothing. The invitation itself was one to SAARC leaders, and the selective leaks to the media after the prime ministerial meeting yesterday suggested that Mr. Modi stuck to a hawkish script instead of a more peaceable one. On the Pakistani side, Mr. Sharif's mantra of business, trade and economy may be music to some ears, but it is in the security arena that many of the key decisions will need to be taken and the battle for control fought. Dawn was not the only section of the Pakistan media that was cynical about Indo-Pak relations. Always on the brink, The Nation. Another editorial in The Nation, which was published yesterday, called Sharif's visit a clever political move. Recalling the then Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee's peace journey to Lahore 15 years ago, the paper said if any real progress was to be made, it must move beyond symbolism. The Prime Minister's visit to Delhi for Narendra Modi's oath-taking ceremony is different, though the hype in the media is similar in lauding the great beginnings of a diplomatic peace process. But that is not what the Prime Minister has gone to Delhi to do. His trip to Delhi is one thing only. It is a smart political move. Image is everything. Goodwill must be seen to exist. It's the modern progressive thing to do. Cleverly, Modi has legitimized a very controversial election by having SAARC leaders, especially the Pakistani Prime Minister, in attendance at his swearing-in. Now, the way Pakistan understands diplomatic theatrics must change. We must focus on formulating policy that can withstand the echoes and shockwaves of history and the routine glitches of our complex and mutual political state. In a separate editorial titled A New Page, the news went all out on Narendra Modi's ideology. The meeting between Nawaz and Modi hinted both at the prospects for peace and the likelihood of trouble in the months ahead. Nawaz focused, as he always has, on engagement, but Modi spoke mostly of terrorism, particularly the Mumbai attacks of 2008. In his own brief remarks to the press, Nawaz once again sung the song of peace. That the word peace can even be uttered with a hardline Modi in power is in itself a testament to the surprising developments of the past few days. A point to note was that the Indian side did bring up specific issues of concern, but the Pakistani Prime Minister talked of our issues only in general diplomatic terms. Modi's ideology remains what it is, and any attack in India is still sure to be blamed on Pakistan, with the inevitable recriminations to follow. If Modi does indeed visit Pakistan, which could be a very distant prospect, we can also expect a lot of hostility stemming from his actions during the massacre of Muslims in Gujarat.